Hey guys, my name is Matsumiao, and today I'm excited to say that we now know all the details surrounding the new season coming to Rainbow Six Siege called Operation Shifting Tides. The first operator that they showed off is named Kali for the offensive team, and she has the potential to be one of the strongest operators that they've introduced in quite some time. Not only does she have access to the first ever bolt action sniper that's ever been in the game, but on top of that, she has a gadget that is going to bring a lot of utility as well. Speaking of that primary weapon, it's going to hit really hard. Not only does it have the ability to go through multiple walls and open up large holes, but it will also one-shot, I believe, every single operator on defense, even if you hit them in the body. Now, it will put them in the down but not out state if you're not able to line up a headshot, so you will need to get that consecutive shot off if you want to remove them from the round, but this thing is going to hit really hard. It doesn't even seem like Rook's armor is going to be a counter here, because I would have guessed that they would have mentioned that in this presentation if that was the case. On top of that, she is going to have the highest optic in the game. It's going to have a 5x zoom and a 12x if you so desire. So this really is going to be a sniper character. If all that wasn't enough though, her gadget, the destructive lens, is also going to provide a lot of utility. This thing can basically destroy any gadget that you throw at it. An evil eye, a castle barricade. You need to be able to take out a mute jammer or a bandit battery that's behind a reinforcement. It will have the ability to do so. Now, you might be thinking right now, okay, this sounds like she's borderline overpowered. Does she have any weaknesses? Thankfully, she does. One of the big ones is that every time that you fire the weapon, it is going to cause a big vapor trail across the screen. And so it's going to be very obvious what direction that she came from. It even has a lingering effect. And so if you're in the vicinity, it's going to be very clear as to which direction that she's trying to take you out. And so you can use that information to your advantage. On top of that, she also has a very slow aim down sight time, and so it's going to be very difficult for her to be able to rush into said objective room, aim down sight, and take you out quickly. She's going to have to take things very slow and methodically. Now, that doesn't mean that she can't play aggressive, because she has access to the C75 secondary, which kind of shores up that weakness. And so if the time is running out and you need to get on to the objective and your primary weapon clearly is going to put you at a disadvantage, you do have that option available. Now, as for her gadget itself, it also comes with some pretty big weaknesses. A lot of people are assuming that because she's essentially Thatcher 2.0, that this is going to make it impossible for you to stop offense from getting through reinforced walls, but that doesn't seem to be the case. Yes, she is going to be very good at basically taking care of every single gadget that comes in her way, but that doesn't mean that she's going to do very well against the bandit trick or a mute that is trying to stop offense. Because the destructive lance does damage on both sides of a reinforcement, that means that if you had a thermite gadget or a Hibana on the wall, and then you use Kali's gadget to take out the mute that was on the opposite side, their gadget alongside the mute is going to be destroyed. And so you're gonna have to coordinate a little bit and wait for her to use hers before you can then proceed to get through that reinforcement. And so it's gonna give anyone on the opposite side plenty of opportunity to react to that, especially with the bandit trick. All in all though, I will fully admit that she looks like she is going to be a force to be reckoned with. A lot of people are already claiming that she's gonna be overpowered, and while it's way too early to tell, I can see where they're coming from. The fact that she brings this much utility and has a one-shot weapon seems like it's going to be a very potent combination. As for the new defensive operator, we have Wamai, who is essentially going to be an alternative to Jaeger. The way that his gadget works is that he essentially has gigantic magnets that he can throw around anywhere. He has the versatility to put this on the ceiling, on the wall, on the floor, wherever he wants, and then any object, pretty much anything that flies in towards its vicinity is going to be dragged towards it. Now, it won't neutralize the nade like Jaeger, and so if you throw in a flash, it is still going to cause that flash effect, but it will hopefully pull it into the part of the room that will essentially make it obsolete. The thing is, though, is that this essentially counters basically everything that offense can throw into said room. This includes gridlock. This means that Kapitao arrows finally have a counter. Capitao right now, especially at higher levels, because he doesn't have a counter currently, is really potent. He is now going to have a counter in the form of Wamai. What I found really interesting about his design is that he's similar to Legion, where his gadget will recharge as the match progresses. And so as long as you're able to stay alive the entire round, you're going to be able to dynamically place a lot of these around the rooms and hopefully react to what offense is doing and slowing down their progress by basically making nades obsolete. He could be a really strong anchor. Another thing that's going to make him an attractive choice is that he is going to have access to the AUG, which makes him the second operator on defense that is able to use one of these kinds of weapons. And so while I don't think that they've confirmed if you're going to be able to use the ACOG on this, he is going to be 2 armor, 2 speed. They have changed their policy lately with regard to the ACOG. They've been giving 2 armor, 2 speeds access to that attachment for a while now. Even if he's only able to use the smaller optics, this is going to be a pretty big deal. I can only imagine the reason why Ubisoft has done this is that they wanted to make him a competitive option to Jaeger. Jaeger right now has a ridiculously high pick rate because his weapon just hits really hard. And so if you want another operator that is going to be an alternative, he better also have a very powerful weapon. And I guess that's kind of where the AUG comes into play. In general, though, I really like the design of this new character. It remains to be seen how competitive he is going to be in the long run, but the fact that he has a gadget that slowly improves as the match goes on, the fact that we're finally going to have a counter, or at least more options to deal with the many gadgets that get thrown onto the objective, I have a suspicion that he is going to be a welcome addition for the defensive team. Another big change that's coming with the start of this new season is the rework of theme park. Probably the biggest change is that they just simply made the map significantly brighter. One of the weaknesses of the old version is that it was just simply too dim on a lot of the sections. This made it not only difficult to be able to identify where certain gadgets were, like Elysian, but also because it was just hard to pinpoint certain operators if they were in these darker sections of the map. And so by brightening things up, that will hopefully make it a bit more competitive. Ubisoft also went on in and just completely removed the train section of the map. The result of this is that now we don't have to deal with that nuisance because it was really obnoxious trying to drone out the thousands of different angles that a defender could hide in, but also it now has made the map smaller. They basically just took the 2 different halves of the map because now the trains are gone and then just kind of squished them together. The spooky part is also gone. It is now a throne room and an armory with a visual update. That's the thing. Basically, everything across this map now looks significantly better, in my opinion. Not only because it's brighter, but really the art team, just in general, did a phenomenal job here. All in all, though, I cannot wait to play on it. Theme Park always felt like it was on the cusp of being competitive, but it was always held back by certain aspects. And so I'm crossing my fingers that Ubisoft was able to shore up some of those weaknesses and deliver something that is a lot of fun. The final couple of things that we're going to be getting with this new season are some gameplay adjustments. One of them is that they are finally, because this has been something that community has been asking since like the very beginning of the game, is that they're improving rappelling. As we all know, if you rappel to the top of a roof, once you hit that threshold, it automatically forces you through an animation and you rappel all the way up to the rooftop itself. The problem with this system, though, is that it never gave the player the agency to choose when and where they wanted to get onto the rooftop. And so if you were doing a reverse rappel, trying to peer through a window upside down, a lot of times you would accidentally reach that threshold and it would force you onto the rooftop. Now you're going to be able to decide. You're now going to have to hit that mantle button if you want to get onto the rooftop, just allowing players that control. And so in the grand scheme of things, this is just going to give players more agency. If you're someone who really likes to rappel and do those reverse upside down strategies, this is going to make your life a lot easier. The final change that is coming is that they're adding in a new system that allows your rounds to penetrate limbs. This means that if someone gets flashed and they have their hand over their face as demonstrated, before it wouldn't actually give you the headshot, but now it does. I cannot tell you how many times that this has happened to me, and so the fact that they have finally added in this kind of a system, I think is a great addition. Yeah guys, that is about it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed. Let me know what you thought about all this information and the new season. Are you excited about the two new operators? What do you think of them? Do you think that they're going to be strong? Are you a little bit worried about them? Give me guys' thoughts down below. But yeah guys, until next time, have a good one and take it easy.